In episode one, we had to climb up Deer Creek Pass, which was no easy task, then down the other side into the Thoroughfare Drainage. Our destination for this part of the trip was Bridger Lake and the Yellowstone River. It took us 3 days to do this. The next morning, I walked over to the Yellowstone River and just pondered on the trip so far and what we still had ahead of us. The rain last night was hard and cold, but we made it through. Alex was out calling the horses in from grazing all night, and we needed to start breakfast. We've got a long ways to go up this drainage, but the Yellowstone River is getting awfully small already. But I can see why the mountain men love this area. It's just full of beaver, the whole area. The remnants of the 1980s fires are still prevalent everywhere you look. Growing season is really short here. It takes a long time to regrow back. On the trail ahead, we found a warning sign. Grizzly spotted in the area on a horse carcass. And yep, there were tracks. About the time we got done with camp chores, got around to them, and thinking about dinner time, it started raining again for about 3 hours tonight, like last night. Thank you. The next morning, we sat around and made some plans. We decided we were going to make a day ride to the headwaters of the Yellowstone River, leaving camp behind us. Alex would sit there and watch the camp and the horses to make sure that grizzly didn't come around. It was breakfast time. We caught four horses, saddled them up, and headed up the river. We were anxious to find out where water starts on the Yellowstone. It was up here someplace. We had to cross the Yellowstone River quite a few times on our journey up canyon. But boy, the mighty Yellowstone River was getting awful small. As we sat in quiet, each one of us just looked out at the majesty of the mountains and over the mighty Yellowstone River that wasn't very big anymore.
Yellowstone.
As we keep going up the drainage, Yellowstone keeps getting smaller and smaller. We made it to the upper headwaters of the Yellowstone River. We could see Yonk's Peak and the Thoroughfare Mountain in the distance. Water was tumbling down from the hillsides from snowbanks from high above, coming down to the valley floor and continuing down. This is where water starts in the Yellowstone River. Changing. It was was time to leave. As we came back down the valley, we stopped one more time to take a photo of us, so we could prove that we were at the headwaters of the Yellowstone River.
Never pass this way again, Roger.
I don't know. I bet I end up back at this castle creek someday.
Yeah, work for me.
Maybe.
I think I'd be a pretty nice boss. I'd like to think I'd be a pretty nice boss. Excuse me, your glasses?
On to tape for that.
Yeah, but those saws were.
Hey.
That didn't look better looking back. Go. Oh, I was born under a wandering star. Do you know where hell is? Hell is in hello. Heaven is goodbye forever. It's time for me to go. I was born under a wandering star, a wandering star.
Yeah, but those saws were.
In the next episode, we will begin our journey out. This will take 3 days, climbing the Woodward Canyon to the Buffalo Plateau, then down the Marston Pass to the Shoshone River below. We were now in some of the most remote wilderness area in the lower 48 states. course, there's more rain on them.